Now look, you see, it's this way like. You cross the broken bridge and run the creek down till you strike the second right-hand ridge. The track is hard to see in parts, but still it's pretty clear. There's been two injured orcas carts along the road this year. Well, run that right-hand ridge along. It ain't, to say, too steep. There's two fresh tracks might put you wrong where blokes went out with sheep. But keep the creek upon your right and follow pretty straight along the spur until you sight a wire and sapling gate. Well, that's where Hogan's old grey mare fell off and broke her back. You'll see a carcass laying there just down below the track. And then you drop 2 mile or three. It's pretty steep and blind. You want to go and fall a tree and tie it on behind. And then you pass a broken cart below a granite bluff. And that is where you strike the part that they reckon's pretty tough. But by the time you've got that far, it's either cure or kill. So turn your horses round the spur and face them up the hill. Look, if you should miss the slope and get below the track, you haven't got the slightest hope of ever getting back. And halfway up, you'll see the hide of Hogan's brindled bull. Well, mind and keep the right-hand side. The left's too steep a pull. And both the banks is full of cracks, and just about as dark. You'll see the last year's bullock's tracks where Hogan's drew the bark. The marks is old and pretty faint, overgrown with scrub and such. Of course, the track to Hogan's ain't a road that's travelled much. But turn and run the tracks along for half a mile or more, and then, of course, you can't go wrong. You're right at Hogan's door. When first you come to Hogan's gate, he mightn't show, perhaps. He's sure to plant and wait to see if it ain't the traps. I wouldn't call it good enough to let your horses out. There's some that's pretty extra rough is living round about. It's likely, if your horses did get feeding near the track, it's gonna cost at least a quid or more to get 'em back. So, if you find they're off the place, it's up to you to go and flash a quid in Hogan's face. He'll know the blokes that know. But listen, if you're feeling dry, just see there's no one near and go and wink the other eye and ask for ginger beer. The blokes come in from round near and far to sample Hogan's pop. They reckon once they breast the bar, they stay until they drop. On Sundays, you can see them spread like flies around the tap. It's like that song, The Living Dead, up there at Hogan's Gap. They like to make it pretty strong whenever there's a chance. So when a stranger comes along, they always hold a dance. There's recitations, songs and fights. A willin' lot you'll meet. There's one long bloke up there recites. I tell you, he's a treat. They're lively blokes all right up there. It's never dull a day. I'd go myself if I could spare the time to get away. The stranger, he turned his horses quick. He didn't cross the bridge. He didn't go along the creek to strike the second ridge. He didn't make the trip because he wasn't feeling fit. His business up at Hogan's was to serve him with a writ. He reckoned if he faced the pull and climbed the rocky stair, the next to come might find his hide a landmark on the mountainside, along with Hogan's brindled bull and Hogan's old grey mare.